Danny Garrison, 65 questions for you. Are you ready?
I'm ready.
Favorite day of the week?
Saturday.
Best SpongeBob episode?
The one where Squidward's laying down just going, future.
Favorite SpongeBob character?
Squidward.
If you could make a cameo in any show on television, what would it be?
It'd be Seinfeld, but I'd want to do the thing that Kramer does where he slides in the room.
Favorite TV show that's not on the air anymore?
How I Met Your Mother, for sure.
How many times a day do you tweet?
You want average or like today?
Both.
Okay, today I think I've tweeted about 7 times. Average, probably take the under, like 5.
Best reaction gif out there?
It's the one where LeBron won the NBA title in 2013, and he's just pointing at someone, just like you.
Favorite thing you've ever tweeted?
During the World Cup, this past summer, I got really pumped when Jermaine Jones scored his goal. So I took a picture of a soaring eagle and said, here's a close-up of the ball going into the goal in all caps, and that got mad love on the Twitter machine.
Do you consider yourself close personal friends with Spurrier?
Yes, but I think it's a different kind of relationship than that, where we just have an understanding, we don't have to say it.
What are your feelings on our football season this year?
I'm a little bit disappointed.
Which sport are you most excited about currently?
I want to see some men's basketball action.
Hashtag you think everyone should stop using.
Anything that's like a full sentence, that really grinds my gears.
Best part about covering games at Williams-Brice?
They get some decent food up there sometimes.
Do you participate in fantasy football?
I participate in several fantasy footballs.
Are you winning in fantasy football?
Right now? In my game? Yeah, in my league. No way.
Are you in the lead for staff picks?
No, I'm in like third. Last year I kind of ran away with it and I think I got cocky.
Best moment in the newsroom?
This one right now. Living the dream.
Weirdest moment in the newsroom?
Hannah's had some weird ones that I'm not going to divulge.
Someone everyone should be following on Twitter?
The Big Spur, because they retweet me a lot.
Dream City?
New York City, I want to do that.
Favorite football team?
The Dallas Cowboys.
How much Natitude do you possess?
Can't really be measured. It's more of a lifestyle. You're either Natitude or you're not. Hashtag Natitude.
Currently playing on your iPod?
CeeLo's Christmas album, CeeLo's Magic Moment.
Favorite artist of the moment?
I've been listening to some Snoop.
Favorite album of the moment?
I think we went over that with CeeLo's Magic Moment.
Best rap lyrics you've ever heard?
Real G's move in silence like lasagna.
Do you have a stockpile of reaction GIFs and photos and just keep them all in your brain so then you Google them, or do you have a folder on your hard drive?
Magician never reveals his tricks.
At what age did you start making finger guns at people?
I think that's kind of how I came out.
What's the key to successfully riding a moped with your bros?
You gotta distance yourself a little bit so you have the option to finger guns people if you ride by them.
If you could describe what your mind looked like, how would you describe it?
A basketball, because ball is life.
Why the Cowboys?
Well, we could get into my family and their military history, or we could just say that the Dallas Cowboys are America's team.
Why the Nationals?
Because I'm from there.
What are your thoughts on the Cowboy cheerleaders?
I'm sure they're very nice girls.
Go-to fast food place?
Firehouse.
What do you normally order at Chipotle?
I'm not big on Chipotle. I took a 2-year hiatus and then I got a burrito bowl last time I was there.
Best place to eat in Russell House?
It's the Horseshoe Deli.
Favorite T-Swift song?
Mine.
How was your 21st birthday?
It was great. I played pickup basketball.
Favorite SpongeBob quote?
Are you feeling it now, Mr. Krabs?
Dream job?
I want to be a backup quarterback that's like a really solidified one, like a Charlie Batch, who just kind of has a job and doesn't have to do much.
One word you think all journalists should stop using?
I've said this before. I think we should stop using the word champion as a verb. I hate that.
Best football game you've ever been to?
It's a toss-up between Georgia from my freshman year and Georgia from this year.
If you can only go to football or basketball games for the rest of your life, which do you choose?
That's a tough one there. I think I choose basketball because of the sheer volume of them. I can go to more.
How many pairs of cool socks do you own, and what are they?
I have dinosaur socks that are kind of the most publicized in my sock collection, but I've also got some tiki head socks, some sharks, palm trees. I think that's the highlights.
Where do you go when you disappear from the newsroom?
Don't worry about it.
What should everyone know about the Daily Gamecock?
That the sports section is really funny, and even if you don't get it, it's your fault, because we are funny.
Weird fact about you that we don't already know.
I lived in Korea.
Stereotypical freshman moment that you experienced.
One time I was walking, and there was a guy coming up on a skateboard behind me, and he kind of ate it, and the board flew in front of me. But I lifted my foot up and stepped on it and looked like a hero and an awesome dude. So is that stereotypical, looking cool in front of everyone?
Coolest person you've ever interviewed?
I interviewed Stephen A. Smith, and he told me that no one gave a shit about me.
How much Nationals attire do you own?
I own like 3 t-shirts and a couple of hats. Hashtag Natitude.
Sport you're really bad at?
I can't play soccer very well. Been working on that, so I'll get back to you.
Sport you're really good at?
Buckets. I get buckets.
If you could have anyone guest write for sports, who would it be?
I want Bob Ryan to write for us. He is on Around the Horn sometimes, and he is known for writing the best gamers in history.
If you could have dinner with anyone living or dead, who would it be?
Tony Romo.
What would you cook for him?
Oh, I'm cooking for Romo? I can make a mean chicken on my griddler with some sweet tea marinade.
Favorite movie of all time?
Hardball. G-baby, RIP.
If you could excel at one sport, what would it be?
Probably soccer, because then I'd be super famous all around the world and not just here in America.
If you got to be really good at one sport but had to lose an arm in order to do so, what sport would you choose?
Getting dark here. If I had to lose an arm, I think we'd have to stick with soccer, because then my skills wouldn't be hampered as much. Although there are some basketball players that have made it work.
Favorite hashtag you've ever used?
Leonard Fournette is the freshman running back at LSU. Hashtag turn down Fournette.
When were you most angry at Spurrier?
Most angry? I've never been angry at Spurrier.
If you could trade places with anyone on staff for a week, who would it be and why?
I want to get inside Drew's head. I trade with Drew.
Next 5 questions are from our staff. If you had to do it all over again, would you still join the newspaper?
Yes.
Favorite color?
The one I'm wearing right now. Just like a nice, chill blue.
If you had to get in a fight with anyone on staff, who do you think would put up the best fight?
I bet Tanner can throw hands.
If you were a movie from your childhood, what movie would you be?
The Land Before Time. I love dinosaurs when I was a little guy.
Last question. Why?
You know, there's just a lot of ways to go, and you gotta do it.
Alright, well Danny, thanks for answering 65 questions.
No problem.